I'm gonna be 100% honest with you guys here. I am an absolute sucker for roundup lists of app recommendations. And I know I'm not the only one because I get asked by you guys for app recommendations all the time. So here we are. Now, my intention this week was to sit down and make a list of app recommendations for the iPhone, and then I was gonna come back next week and make a companion video for the Android people, but what I found out when I started making my list is that the majority of my picks are actually cross-platform these days, with very few exceptions. So instead of making two very redundant videos, I've decided just to take the iOS and Android halves and smash them together into one delicious peanut butter and jelly sandwich of a video, and in this video, I'm gonna be giving you 10 specific productivity app recommendations you should check out. And fittingly, we are going to be starting with my to-do list recommendation. Now, when it comes to to-do list apps, I personally use a very powerful app called Asana, and I absolutely love it. However, Asana is built mainly for teams, and it's got a lot of features you probably won't need if you're just managing your personal tasks. So, if you're not managing a team like I am, I recommend Wunderlist. It's elegantly designed, it has apps on iOS, Android, and lots of other platforms, and it doesn't lock essential features behind a paid version like some other to-do managers do. Now, every good task management app needs a calendar app as a companion, and while Google Calendar and iCal are both good, Fantastical is my calendar app of choice. The design is great, it's one of the few calendar apps that features complication support on my Apple Watch, but the killer feature for me is the natural language processing. Instead of typing out events, I can speak them, and the app will intelligently parse what I say and fill in event details automagically. Fantastical does not have an Android version, and the only Android app I could find that has a similar natural language feature is Today Calendar, which is around $5 after a free trial. Now, if you don't want to pay that much and you can live without the language processing feature, I'd recommend checking out SolCalendar for a free, full-featured alternative. Habit tracking is another practice that helps me stay productive, and my favorite app for that is Habitica. Along with a full-featured web app, Habitica has iOS and Android apps that let you turn tracking your habits into a video game. You can level up a character, you can buy gear, and you can join up with other people to go on quests and keep each other accountable. You'll also find a College Info Geek guild within Habitica that has over 7,000 members. Now, if those video game features aren't your cup of tea, but you still want to track your habits, I'd recommend checking out an app on iOS called Momentum, which lets you simply open the app, check a box, and move on with your life. You can also check off habits within iOS's Today View, which is a really cool feature. On Android, check out Habitbull for something that has similar features. For managing notes, my app of choice has always been Evernote. This app is pretty much my second brain. I write all my scripts in it, I take notes in it, and I shove all sorts of information in it that I want to remember. Now, Evernote is cross-platform, but if you own more than two devices, which is the limit on Evernote's free tier, you may want to give Microsoft's OneNote a look as a possible alternative. I prefer Evernote personally, but I am a premium user, and the apps are pretty comparable, and I think OneNote does offer more on the free tier than Evernote does. Anyway, well, Evernote is keeping my notes managed and synced. To keep files synced and backed up across all my devices, I use Dropbox. It integrates amazingly with Asana, which lets me attach files to tasks in the blink of an eye, and overall, I consider it to be one of the most crucial tools in my work setup. Next up, we've got Scannable, an app that lets you automatically scan documents and send them straight to Evernote. Other than my idea notebook and sketchbook, I try to keep my life as paperless as possible, and Scannable lets me do that really, really easily. Now, if you're not an Evernote user though, I would check out ScanBot, which offers a lot of different export options. Additionally, it's also the app you should check out if you're on Android, since Scannable is an iPhone exclusive. Now, if you often find yourself getting distracted by your smartphone while you're working, you've got a couple of different options. Number one, turn it off. But number two, if that doesn't work, you can download Forest, which is an app that rewards you for leaving your phone alone by growing a virtual tree. Now, if you touch your phone before a session is up, the tree dies. You also get a record of your progress, and the positive reinforcement that provides may be just the thing you need to improve your focus. Speaking of focus, one of my favorite ways of getting focused on a particular task is by using the Pomodoro technique, and there are a ton of Pomodoro-style timer apps out there. Feel free to check out as many as you like, but on the iPhone, I'd recommend going with FocusKeeper, while those of you on Android should check out Clear Focus. Lastly, one practice that helps me stay productive throughout the entire day is exercising, which is why I use an app called the 7-Minute Workout pretty much every single day. And this just helps me make sure that even on the days I don't go to the gym, I'm still getting some exercise in. So guys, that is my list, at least for this particular video. Now, I definitely have more apps on this bad boy that I use and want to share with you, so I'm gonna do more app roundup videos in the future, and if you've got app picks of your own, you can share them down in the comments below. Before I wrap this video up, I did wanna let you guys in on one more thing, and that is that College Info Geek t-shirts are now in stock over at dftba.com, and if I can stand on my tiptoes enough, you can kind of see the shirt, because I'm wearing it right now, but you can see the full picture at the link in the description, and if you click that link, you can also buy a shirt if you want. If you do get one and you want to send me a picture of it, you can tweet me over at Tom Frankly, and you can also use my Twitter to ask me questions, which I'll use for future videos and future Q&A rapid fire lightning style round video things. And that about does it for this week's video, guys. So if you enjoyed it and you want to get new videos every single week on being a more effective student, you can click that subscribe button right over there. And if you want to get a free copy of my book on earning better grades, you can click the picture right there. Click there to find another video you might enjoy, and you'll find more helpful resource links in the description below the like button, which you can hit to support this channel. See ya!